pulsation dampening demonstration, we're using a peristaltic pump, also called a hose pump. It's called a hose pump because inside the case there is a hose and the pumping action is derived by using either one, two, or three roller shoes. For this video, we have removed the front of the hose pump to provide a better view of the hose and roller shoes. At the pump inlet, a roller shoe squeezes the hose, trapping liquid in the tube ahead of it. As the roller shoe rotates, liquid is pushed out of the pump's discharge. When the roller shoe releases the hose, after discharge, a momentary void or pocket is created where there is no product. This creates a partial vacuum as some product is actually sucked back to the discharge momentarily. This action, along with the normal pulsing action created by its positive displacement nature, makes the peristaltic pump very difficult to dampen the discharge flow. You will notice that the flow is pulsing as it comes out the discharge and that there is a very large swing in pressure on the pressure gauge. The flow actually stops at every rotation of a roller shoe. As we activate the dampener by opening an isolation valve, you'll notice that instantly the flow becomes steady and smooth, centrifugal-like, and that the needle on the pressure gauge is nearly stabilized, indicating that there are no more pressure swings, thus protecting piping and other system components. And again, as we deactivate the dampener, you will see the pulsation and the wide variation in pressure. Activating the dampener again immediately smooths the flow and eliminates the wild pressure swings. While the inlet stabilizer is not pictured in this demonstration, the same pressure and pulse action occurs at the pump's inlet. As a roller shoe passes across the pump inlet and closes it off, flow into the pump will momentarily stop. If the pump inlet is under positive pressure, acceleration head will cause a pressure spike and vibration, causing potential damage to pipe and components. If the pump inlet is under vacuum, cavitation and pump starvation can occur. These situations can be eliminated or minimized by the installation of BLACOH inlet stabilizers. Pump hose life may be extended and pipe and other components will be protected.